This video will demonstrate the process of using a slicker plate standard, sometimes called a slicker standard or slicker, to calibrate a field standard test measure following the process described in NIST IR 7383 SOP 18. The slicker plate standard is a calibrated standard having a known volume, gravimetrically determined, between the plane of the ground top flange surface and the upstream face of the drain valve. These same steps are also applicable to NIST IR 7383 SOP 19. During the video, some process times will be accelerated. A clock visible in the lower right of the frame will let you know the actual amount of elapsed process time. Before beginning the calibration, we wet down the system by performing many of the same steps that are used in the actual calibration, but without recording any data, ensuring that all specified pour and drain times are observed during the wet down process. After emptying the slicker plate standard into the test measure during wet down, allow the water to remain in the test measure while refilling the slicker plate standard for the first test measure calibration run. Do not shortcut the process, or measurement errors will occur. Now, I'll demonstrate the wet down process. I've completed the wet down in preparation for carrying out the calibration procedure. Next, I'll demonstrate the procedure and at the same time explain each of the 9 steps that make up the process. As I go, I will provide some hints about things to avoid that can result in measurement errors. Step 1, the slicker plate standard is filled. As that is done, it's best to run the fill tube to the bottom of the standard to minimize air bubbles in the water. The slicker plate standard is filled until the water mounds up higher than the surface of the slicker plate flange due to water surface tension. Step 2. Measure and record the temperature of the water in the slicker plate standard. Step 3. The standard is slicked off. As the slicker plate slides into position, notice that the edge of the slicker plate is brought in at a slight down angle to prevent trapping air under the slicker plate. Once the plate is covering the top of the standard, verify that no air is trapped under the slicker plate. Any trapped air will result in a measurement error. Step 4. Now the test measure is emptied following the pour and drain times specified in NIST Handbook 105-3 for the device being calibrated. The pour portion of the transfer process will be accelerated, but the on-screen clock will show actual pour time. Pour the water from the test measure in a controlled and reasonably constant rate. For handheld field standard test measures, this is a 30-second pour and 10-second final drain. Hold handheld test measures at a 10 to 15 degree angle from vertical for the final drain period. Then position the empty test measure under the slicker plate standard drain valve or piping so no water is lost during the transfer process. Step 5. The slicker plate is removed while simultaneously opening the slicker plate standard drain valve. It is vital that the valve be opened at the exact instant or immediately following the back edge of the slicker plate, clearing the inner edge of the flange so air can enter the standard. If the valve is open before the edge of the plate clears the flange, any water on the underside of the slicker plate around the flange may be drawn into the standard, resulting in a measurement error. Step 6. The slicker plate standard is allowed to empty until there is cessation of the main water flow. Then a 30-second count begins. At exactly 30 seconds, the valve is closed and the slicker plate standard is moved so that no further drainage into the test measure is possible. Further drainage will result in a measurement error. Step 7. Verify that the neck of the test measure is vertical or perpendicular to a level horizontal plane by placing a level on the side of the neck as specified in NIST Handbook 105-3. Do not place it across the top as you might be tempted to do. In step 8, the level of the liquid in the test measure is read on the sight gauge scale by placing a card with a black half and a white half to properly indicate the bottom of the meniscus. Placing the black portion of the card just below the meniscus causes the bottom of the meniscus to reflect the black surface against the white top of the card. Besides the card, other meniscus reading aids like a magnifying glass can be helpful. After taking the reading, the value is recorded. And lastly, step 9. Measure the temperature of the water in the test measure and record it. Note that this measurement is made after reading and recording the scale plate reading, as water may be removed by the thermometer during the measurement, resulting in an error. Then compare the temperature of the water in the slicker plate standard and the temperature of the water in the test measure to ensure that the difference is less than the specified limit, as determined by the materials from which the standard and test measure are made. If the maximum difference is exceeded, the calculations of SOP 19 should be performed, or the data discarded and a new calibration run performed from the beginning. If the temperature difference is acceptable, this data is used as run 1, and the entire process is repeated to gather data for run 2. That's what I'll do now. Run the whole process again, nonstop, with only on-screen text to introduce each step for run 2. You have just seen the calibration of a handheld field standard test measure using a slicker plate standard as the reference. The calculations to determine the actual prover volume are detailed in the SOP. Sample calculations can be downloaded from the website where this video is provided. One last note, if there is more than 0.2 cubic inch disagreement between the scale readings for runs 1 and run 2, check all vessels for cleanliness, leaks, or other damage. Identify and correct any problems. Such problems must be corrected before an acceptable calibration can be completed. Also, as you likely noticed, we have not addressed the adjustment and sealing of the test measure for legal metrology use. These topics will be addressed in future video or podcasts.